in the past, we honor those coaches, cheerleaders, and players who brought us the miracle season. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1981 state champion football Buckeyes. Players and coaches with us tonight, as we read the 1981 roster, please walk to midfield as your name is called. But before we call those names, the 1981 state champions ask for a moment of silence in recognition of our lost teammates, Patrick Bookman, Phil Jones, Denny Milliron, and Willie Murray. These champions are sadly missed by their teammates and the whole Nelsonville, York community. They will not be forgotten. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the 1981 state champion, Nelsonville, York Buckeyes. Cheerleaders with us this evening: Diane Boston, Kim Hickman, and Teresa Johnson. Once again, those cheerleaders, Diane Boston, Kim Hickman, and Teresa Johnson. The 1981 roster: Eric Robson, Pat Boyer, Brad Woodson, Philip Metcalf, Eric Maurer, Tom Taggart, Kelly Smith, Andy Grinstead, Brian McQuaid, Gary Easterling, Brian Smathers, Jeff Talbert, Mike Bishop, Trent Gallanton, Bob McDonald, Natu Patel, Tony Midkiff, Jim Wallace, John Wallace, Monty Bear, Scott Mount, Brian Mays, Greg Martin, Steve Yinger, Ron Norway, Bill Newland, Pat Ashworth, Scott Dane, Greg Jones, Darrow Tolliver, Jeff Addis, Mike Conrad, Dwayne Andrews, Mark Metcalf, Bill Lanning, Lee Clark, Troy Davis, Greg Kirkendall, Jeff Adams, Eric Money, Doug Steenrod, Jason Andrews, Donnie Swires, Ross Flowers, Jim Martin, Troy Day. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1981 Nelsonville, York Buckeyes coaching staff: Bob Richards, Doug Durth, Tom Brewer, Jack Sowers, Rob Weinfurtner, Rocky Smathers, Tom McLaughlin, and head coach Dave Boston Sr. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1981 state champion, Nelsonville York Buckeyes.
Yeah, I got it. gentlemen, please rise and join us as our bands come together on this special night to perform our national anthem, the Star-Spangled Banner. The Star-Spangled Banner will be conducted this evening by Mr. Mike Eubanks.
Guys about ready to make their way on the Boston field. Chance Fox on camera, Ray Spouts, Jim McCumber here on Nelsonville TV Cables, Channel 15, the Chieftains and the Buckeyes from Boston Field.
It's an electric night tonight, Jim, with both the Chieftains and the Buckeyes ready to roll.
And here come the Buckeyes. Nelsonville York coming in 4-0 on the season. Logan 0-4, but of course Logan playing the likes of Lancaster and
Pickerington North,
Reynoldsburg.
Jackson, Reynoldsburg. I mean, you know, that's the thing. You don't want to look at the records in these two teams. You don't want to look at 4-0 and 0-4. You want to forget about that altogether because the competition that both teams have played, completely different. The reality is, this is a pretty tight matchup for both teams. I feel this is a great contest for the Buckeyes, a great test for them. You know, we've been talking about it for the first 4 weeks. They're looking to get into the playoffs, and not just win a playoff game, but move forward and do something really big into the playoffs this year. With the inspiration of the 1981 championship team here, it's just a great environment tonight, Jim.
Of course, the Buckeyes playing pretty good competition themselves, playing Newark Catholic, a perennial power school, and of course Bishop Reedy last week. Nelsonville York defeats Bishop Reedy 47-13 last week up in Columbus.
Well, you know, that's we talked about it earlier. We knew Trimble was going to be down this year, so after that game we kept saying, hey, look towards Newark Catholic. After Newark Catholic game, we were looking towards the Bishop Reedy game. And the Buckeyes have been able to come up against any, you know, ally against, or opposition against them to this point and really play extremely hard for four quarters. And I really attribute that to the fact that we've talked about this all season, Jim. The ability of the Buckeyes to move players on and off the line, both offensively and defensively, have different skill players, different defensive players, and there's very few kids that have to play both ways the entire game.
Nick Cost will kick it away for Logan. Nelsonville York with Austin North, Garrison Breeze, and Dustin Young back deep. And this game's ready to get underway at Boston Field.
Nick Cost, just a sophomore for the Chieftains.
Short kick, takes a bounce at the 24. Picked up by Garrison Breeze. Takes it to the middle of the field, gets spun around, breaks a tackle. And Garrison Breeze will take it out to the 43-yard line. Buckeyes with excellent field position after the nice return by Garrison Breeze.
One of those situations, Jim, where the kickoff is a little bobbled at the end, and it just seems to take the coverage team out of sync when that type of thing happens, and it always gives an opportunity for the returning team to get a nice return, and the Buckeyes make the most of it. Breeze gets right up the center of the field, across the 40 for a great starting field position here tonight.
Nathan Dean, 43 of 59 on the season passing, 713 yards and 7 touchdowns. Buckeyes out of the eye, 2 receivers to the right. Fake handoff, Dean throws. He's got his man Perkins out of the backfield. He's got a first down and more in the Logan territory, and he's driven out at the 39-yard line.
Close to 20 yards. I think they're going to mark this about an 18-yard gain.
There is a flag down on the far side. It looks like this one may be coming back, holding on Nelsonville York.
That is the call. But you see the Buckeyes come out, obviously, learning from what they did last week, Jim. Last week, their first half of the game, Nathan Dean was 9 of 12 for 181 yards. Really opened up the field and gave the running game an opportunity to do things because the passing game was so effective. And the Buckeyes come out strong. First play of the game, they come out passing the ball, and they're looking to do the same thing. Spread that field, make the defense watch both aspects of the game.
Penalty from the spot of the foul. The Buckeyes will have a first and 11 back on their own 42. North comes in motion to this side. Dean pitches it out. Dustin Young comes to this side. Dustin Young across the 45, the 50, the 45 of Logan, and down to the 37-yard line of the Chieftains.
He's finally brought down by, looks to be number 50 and 24. 24 is Corey McCarty. 50 is Alex Schneider on the stop there for the Chieftains. But a great blocking scheme on the left side for the Buckeyes that time. If you notice, Daniel Klein did a great job of taking his man out. Dustin cuts up underneath him. The fullback was right in front of him. I believe that to be Perkins. Made a nice block and really freed up a great run for the Buckeyes.
Nathan Dean out of the shotgun. Looking on the right side, throws, and it is pulled in. And it's down to the Logan 33, a gain of about 4 yards for the Buckeyes. Garrison Breeze with the catch. Buckeyes starting that left end, number 21, Daniel Klein. Left tackle, 78, Isaac Andrews. Left guard, 57, Austin McCalla. Center, 61, Kyle Moore. Right guard, 74, Tucker Johnson. Right tackle, 65, Isaiah Mello. Right end, 20, Garrison Breeze. Wing back, number 9, Mark Carter. Fullback 28, Jacob Perkins. Tailback 10, Dustin Young. Quarterback number 11, Nathan Dean. Buckeye second down and about 7. Handoff goes to Dustin Young on the right side. And let's see what he gets. Pickup of about 2 on the play. The Buckeyes will have a 3rd and 5.
Number 24, McCarty on the stop there again for the Chieftains over the right-hand side. It's interesting to watch the lineup of the defense of the Chieftains right now. They're actually leaving a huge hole in the middle of that line, Jim. If you watch that, look how much of a gap is between their linemen. They're allowing that linebacker to try to read everything.
Buckeyes, 3 receivers to the right, 2 to the left. Dean back to pass, throws, and it's pulled in. And it's Dustin Young, and he'll go down right around the 14-yard line of Logan. That's a Buckeye first down.
He was actually drug out of bounds by number 7, Josh Friedley, that time. And you're right, he gets inside the 20 down at close to the 18.
Dustin Young with 6 catches for 66 yards coming into this game. Buckeyes first and 10 inside the 19-yard line of Logan. Buckeyes out of the eye, 2 receivers to the right. Hand off, Dustin Young up the middle. Young takes it down close to the 10-yard line as he picks up about 8 yards.
Yeah, and that's right where I was just talking about, exploiting that middle. As long as you can get that center, Kyle, actually off the ball as soon as he snaps it to rush out and take out that middle linebacker, that middle is going to be wide open for at least the first 5 yards. A great chunk of yards that time. Nice 8-yard run by Dustin Young that time right up the middle.
Buckeyes out of the eye. 2 receivers to the right once again on 2nd and 2.
And Logan puts a nose guard in there this time and
Dustin
tries to block
Young
that off.
Dustin Young takes it up the middle, and it looks like he's got a Buckeye first down around the 7-yard line. Buckeyes will have a first and goal. 9:22 to play in the first quarter. This is the initial drive of this game.
Well, you know what? And it's always been Coach Boston's theory to get the ball first, try to put the points on the board, and put the pressure on the other team. And this Nelsonville York Buckeye offense is marching right down the field just to the tune of Coach Boston's will right now.
First and goal from the Logan 7. Kyle Moore snapping the football for the Buckeyes. Nathan Dean at quarterback. Hands it off on a slant coming back this way. Touchdown Buckeyes, Austin North.
That was a great fake by Nathan that time. I tell you what, Nathan turned, faked that pitch, and it just froze the defense. And as Austin's coming up underneath him, just hands that ball off, and Austin's a quick back. You could see the speed that time, and he just did a little sidestep going into the end zone. Touchdown, Buckeyes. 9 minutes to go. The Buckeyes get the ball. 3 minutes in, got the first points on the board. Great showing by the offense of the Buckeyes.
Nathan Dean will attempt the point after touchdown. Jacob Perkins snapping, Dustin Young holding. And it's a fake. Dean looking to throw. Does so, and it's caught.
Oh.
Did he get in? No, he did not. The two-point conversion attempt fails, but the Buckeyes lead 6-0 with 8:59 to play in the first quarter. Nathan Dean will kick it away for the Buckeyes.
Great start here for the Buckeye offensively. Put the first points on the board and lead 6-0.
Squib kick taken by an up man. And he'll go down at the 35-yard line. Nice hit by the Buckeyes.
Dakota Hook in there on the coverage for the Buckeyes that time and just lays a lick on number 14, Zach Dixon. Now the up man that picked the ball up, and, you know, he went nowhere. He got about 5 yards, and then Dakota just put the lick on him right there.
Quarterback for Logan is Kelly Long. He's 42 of 86 for 597 yards and 3 touchdowns. Corey McCarty, the tailback, has rushed 54 times, 315 yards and 3 touchdowns.
And that's one of the things you'll see right there. McCarty's one of their main backs, but he's also extremely active on the defensive side of the ball for the Chieftains.
Handoff goes to McCarty, and he'll take it out to about the 40-yard line. He picks up 5. It'll bring up 2nd and 5.
First tripped up by Daniel Klein, and then Dakota Hook brings him down.
8:38 to play in the first quarter. Buckeyes lead 6-0. Chieftains splitting out a receiver to each side. 2nd down and about 4.
Buckeyes start out in a 5-man front on the defensive side of the ball. Ooh.
And flags come in. And it is offsides on Nelsonville York. So that will be a first down for the Chieftains. First down on their own 46-yard line.
You know, the Buckeyes last week against Bishop Reedy started out in the first quarter trading blows with Bishop Reedy, and then were able to finally settle down defensively. Buckeyes strike first here. It'll be interesting if we can put a stop on these Chieftains early.
Long pitches it out. McCarty takes it back to the center of the field, and he has a nice gain as he picks up about 8 yards for Logan to the Buckeye 46.
Nice cutback that time by McCarty as that was initially designed, obviously, to go to the right. He saw the seam cut back to the left and shot right up the middle, and like you said, got 8 positive yards before Daniel Klein was able to bring him down.
2nd down and about 2 for the Chieftains, just outside the Buckeye 45. Two receivers to the far side, and we have an official's timeout. Looks like an equipment problem on the Logan side.
Got a chin strap that needs strapped up there. You know, this is one of the bigger lines the Buckeyes defense has had to come up against. So, you know, we're talking about the different tests that they've had. This is one of the things that you've got to watch this evening is the battle at the line.
Hand off to the first man through. The Buckeyes right there, and it looks like he stopped short of a first down. He picks up 1. It'll bring up 3rd and 1.
That was number 36, Michael Simpson, on the carry that time. And Kuhn and Covert bring him down right, like you said, right at the line of scrimmage. Nice job by the Buckeye defense to eat that one up.
Buckeye starting left end, 61, Kyle Moore. Left tackle, 70, Jacob Kuhn. Right tackle, 76, Neil Polly. Right end, 65, Isaiah Mello. Linebacker, 16, Dakota Hook. Linebacker, 54, Caleb Covert. We'll get the rest of them after this play. 3rd down and 1 for the Chieftains at the Buckeye 44. And the Buckeye's in the backfield, and he'll go down for a loss. Corey McCarty does.
That was Covert shooting in from his linebacker position. And I was just going to make the comment. If you notice, the Buckeyes brought in Cody Walker and put him on the far defensive end, which allows them to take Kyle Moore off the defensive end position and put him down on the line, and he's just a strong force down there. They did that last week against Bishop Reedy, but the five-man front, they occupied the entire line, gave Covert just a clear shot in the backfield.
Chieftains will go for it. Fourth and two at the Buckeye 46. Two receivers on the side. He fumbled the ball, and the Buckeyes are going to hold. Buckeyes hold on downs and will take over on their own 46.
The Buckeye defensive line just had an awesome push that time, and it just disrupted the entire rhythm of the offense for the Chieftains, and that play was going nowhere from the get-go. Huge turnover on the fourth down for the Buckeyes defensively.
Let's get the rest of the defensive starters for the Buckeyes, and just made a great play. Outside linebacker 44, Bobby Lightwine. Outside linebacker 21, Daniel Klein. Cornerback 28, Jacob Perkins. Cornerback number 2, Austin North. And free safety number 20, Garrison Breeze. Handoff, Dustin Young, and a big game for Dustin Young as he picks up about 7 of the Logan 47.
Looked like Michael Simpson on the stop there, number 36. I missed the other individual, but it was a nice, again, hole that Dustin was able to get through on the left-hand side over and get that positive 7 yards.
Second and 3 for the Buckeyes at the Chieftain 47. Nelsonville York out of the eye. Hand off Dustin Young up the middle. Big hole. Dustin Young, first down to the Logan 38. Picks up 9.
We're going to give the tackle to number 7, Josh Fridley, or Friedley. But I'll tell you the truth, Dustin just ran right over him that time, and he just powered right through the middle of that line.
Mark Carter coming in with the Buckeye play. First down and 10, Nelsonville York at the 39 of Logan. Nathan Dean at quarterback.
Logan shows blitz.
Hand off Mark Carter. And there goes Clint
Handa.
Handa's
gone!
And he's going to take it all the way. 39 yards out for Clint Handa.
Right there, as I hollered, that they were showing blitz. The Buckeye offensive line and the lead blockers did such an exceptional job that Handa went through that line, and once he was 3 yards deep, there was nobody that was going to touch him. There was nobody there. The Buckeye offensively their line just absolutely did an exquisite job of blocking that time. And Handa just made short business of that one. 39 yards later, puts it in the end zone.
Let's see if the Buckeyes elect to go for 2 this time after the fake and not getting it on the first touchdown. Nelsonville York will take a timeout. They lead 12-0, 5:13 to play in the first quarter. Buckeyes will go for 2. They're going out of the Wildcat with Austin North at quarterback. Nathan Dean is split out wide left. Klein goes in motion to the right. Option to the right.
Nice block
North
over there.
Looking to keep it himself. Ooh. And he's not going to make it in. Nice tackle on the far side by the Chieftains.
Great play that time defensively for the Chieftains.
Looked like it might have been Sean Watring on the tackle.
That, I was going to say it was either 33 or 32. I couldn't pick it up across the field, but I'd give it to Watring also. Nice job by the Chieftains to hold against that two-point conversion.
Buckeyes lead 12-0, 5:13 to play, first quarter. Nathan Dean will kick it away for Nelsonville York. Last time he kicked a squibber. Let's see what he does this time.
Puts it away this time.
We're taking on the far side, right around the 11-yard line. Return man. Buckeyes good coverage, and he'll take it out to the 22.
Yeah, I'll give the Buckeyes coverage that time to Jacob Blake and Austin Immon on the stop.
5:08 to play in the first quarter. Buckeyes up 12-0. They spotted at the 23 of the Chieftains. They have their second possession, first down and 10.
First offensive series for the Chieftains. The Buckeyes were able to shut them down on a fourth in about 2, maybe 3 yards. Get the ball back, see what they can do this time.
Hand off. Goes to McCarty, and he has a nice gain. The ball is loose, and the Buckeyes on it at the Chieftain 40.
Garrison Breeze comes up with the coverage. I'm not sure who caused the fumble. You know, it's one of those things. McCarty was in there kind of spinning around backwards, and when he spun around the second time, the ball just came flying out of there, and Garrison did a great job to recover that ball.
That is something that has plagued Logan. I believe they had 5 turnovers last week against Jackson. Buckeyes first and 10 at the Chieftain 40. Buckeyes out of the eye, two receivers to the right.
Huge opportunity here for the Buckeye offensively. Have already been able to put two scores.
Fake to Dustin Young. Open long. Daniel Klein comes back for it. Pulls it in. Touchdown, Daniel Klein.
I'm looking around. I see no flags. That's a 40-yard pass play from Nathan Dean down to Daniel Klein. Touchdown, Buckeyes, third of the evening. And again, we were just talking about this in the break, Jim, but that's the third touchdown. It's been three different players. We've had Austin North, we've had Clint Handa, we've had now Daniel Klein score touchdowns for the Buckeyes offensively. Dustin Young still be on the board.
This time the Buckeyes will attempt the point after touchdown, leading 18-0. That play went for 40 yards, Dean to Klein. And the kick by Nathan Dean is up.
Good.
And it is good. 4:51 to play in the first quarter. The Buckeyes lead 19-0. Nathan Dean kicking it away once again for Nelsonville York.
Boy, if you're a Nelsonville York fan or coach, you couldn't have scripted a better beginning to this ball game here, Jim. The Chieftains have had the ball twice. Once a turnover on the fourth down and once a fumble recovery by the Buckeye defense. And all three times the Buckeyes have had it, they've scored.
Short kick to the far side, taken at the 26. And the return man goes down right around the 34-yard line. That's where the Chieftains will have their third possession.
I believe it was number 65 on the return that time for the Chieftains, Alan Mulford. And the Buckeyes did a nice job of, again, recovering on that short kick. Stop him at the 35-yard line.
These teams have met 27 times so far. Logan has won 21 of them, the Buckeyes 6, and 5 of those 6 victories, but the Buckeyes resulted in an undefeated season. A little pass out to the side here. It is pulled in. And the Buckeyes right there. That will be a gain of about 3 out to the 37-yard line for the Chieftains. Bring up 2nd and 7. Isaac Lindsay on the catch.
Coon and Mello on the stop that time for the Buckeyes defensively. But they read that play very well. Bobby Lightline was out there real quick to hold that to a 2-yard gain before it went anywhere.
2nd and 7 for the Chieftains on their own 36-yard line. Two receivers split out to the far side. Kelly Long at quarterback for Logan. Hands it off to McCarty on the left side, and he goes down quickly. He picks up 1 to the 37.
Wow, Dakota Hook in there again from his linebacker position. Just, again, the defensive line of the Buckeyes do such a good job of occupying the offensive line of the opposition. It gives that linebacker such free rein to view what's going on, and he read that play perfectly and nailed him as he was coming across the line.
Dakota Hook leading the Buckeyes in tackles coming into this game with 32. Caleb Covert with 24. Third down and about 6 for the Chieftains on their own 38. Long takes a snap, rolls to the far side, throws, and it is incomplete. A flag comes in, and let's see if it's interference on Nelsonville York.
I think they're going to call Bobby Lightwine just hitting number 7, the intended receiver, Josh Friedley, just a little early that time.
And that was actually Jack Music at quarterback for the Chieftains. I was saying Kelly Long.
Didn't even notice the change, Jim. Nice. I was actually looking at the pressure that Daniel Klein was coming off the defensive end that time. He put great pressure on that quarterback to force him to actually try to make that throw. And I, you know, Buckeyes might have had an interception there if it wasn't for the penalty against the Buckeyes that time.
Jack Music still quarterback for the Chieftains. Pitch out, goes to McCarty on the left side, and he'll go down after a gain of 2 to the Buckeye 45.
Perkins made a nice tackle along with Perkins or Hook that time for the Buckeyes, as McCarty only gets about 2 yards, and he got clobbered as he came across the line that time.
2nd down and 8 for Logan at the Nelsonville York 45. Buckeyes up 19-0, 2:48 to play, first quarter. Two receivers split out wide to this side of the field. Music takes a snap, hands it off, and Buckeye's right there.
Wow.
Nothing doing for the Chieftains. He may have got a yard with the forward progress. And he does. It'll bring up third and about seven at the Buckeye 44.
Kuhn and Neil Pauley on the inside that time, along with Covert and Hook coming in from the linebacker. Just great job by the entire defensive side for the Buckeyes.
Again, Jack Music at quarterback for the Chieftains. Third down and seven at the Buckeye 44.
Looked like there was
pass out on this side. It is caught by Lindsay.
Nice
and he's
tackle.
Taken down at the 39, about 3 yards shy of a first down.
Bobby Lightwine made a great open field tackle from behind that time.
We mentioned Dakota Hook leading the Buckeyes in tackles. Caleb Covert second, and Bobby Lightwine close behind with 21 tackles for the Buckeyes coming into this game. So fourth down now and about three.
Second fourth down attempt here for the Chieftains offensively in the first quarter. The first time they were unsuccessful. We'll see what happens this time around.
Actually fourth down and two for the Chieftains. Music at quarterback, a receiver on each side. And handoff goes to McCarty.
Oh, he got around him.
And McCarty has the first down as he takes it to the Buckeye 32-yard line.
Brought down by Perkins and Kuhn as he got around the right side that time, or left side that time.
1:12 to play in the opening quarter here at Boston Field. Nelsonville York 19, Logan nothing.
Well, the Chieftains offensively have had three third downs. They were able to convert on one only because the Buckeyes gave them a penalty. And two fourth down attempts, they were able to convert one out of those two.
Music takes a snap, pitches it out to McCarty on the far side. Buckeyes right there as he goes down right around the 30-yard line, a gain of two. See where they spot it. They'll spot it at the 31, just a gain of one for McCarty.
And you could hear that time. They gave credit to Covert, Klein, Perkins. When you try to go wide on the Buckeyes defensively, there's just so much speed on the corners on both sides. It's hard to get around those ends. And you can see right there, that play looked like it had somewhere to go, but the Buckeyes defensively just swarmed the ball and shut it off before it got anywhere.
Pass out on this side. It's deflected, and it falls incomplete. Nice job of the Buckeyes getting the hands up.
Nice job defensively from the defensive line that time for the Buckeyes to get up there and put a paw up there and knock that ball away before it got going anywhere.
Third and nine at the Nelsonville York, 31.
My guess is it was Mello. I wasn't watching it. I was actually watching down here at the receiver, but my guess would be Mello on this side was the one that got his hands up.
Receiver split out on each side. Third and nine. Jack Music at quarterback for the Chieftains. Option comes this side. He keeps it himself, and he gets it down to the Buckeye 27, where it'll bring up a fourth down and about five.
And Kuhn and Dakota Hook on the stop there again for the Buckeyes.
And Logan will have to run the play. The game clock at 18 seconds, the play clock at 19. Fourth down and about five for the Chieftains at the Buckeye 27. Music looking to throw, does so, and it's picked off for the Buckeyes. Could that be Jacob Perkins on the far side?
I believe it was. Again, Perkins just times that out so well. He was just eyeballing that from the very get-go. Music pulls back, looks to his left. You could see where he was going the entire time, but Perkins does such a great job at jumping those routes. You've seen him all season long just going after interceptions.
You know what that means. It's time for Garrison Breeze to get one a little later.
Yeah.
They each had three leading the Buckeyes coming into this game.
Well, that's a second big turnover for the Buckeyes now. Offensively, the Chieftains are struggling to try to move the ball, and every time they do, the Buckeyes find a way to take it away from them.
Carter in motion to this side. Quick pitch goes to Dustin Young. Dustin Young has a hole, crosses the 40, the 45, and is pushed out of bounds in Logan territory at the 47. And that'll be the final play of the first quarter. And what a nice quarter it's been for the brown, orange, and white. They lead the Chieftains 19-0 at the end of one. Buckeyes first and 10 at the Logan 46 as we begin the second quarter of play.
As we ended that first quarter, as no time on the clock, Dustin Young scampers for 24 yards for the Buckeyes.
And we have a legal procedure. Buckeyes will have a first and 15 back on their own 49-yard line. Jacob Perkins jogging in with the Buckeye play on this first and 15. Nelsonville York on their own 49.
Again, the Buckeyes only had the ball for about 4.5 minutes in the first half, while the Chieftains had it 7.5 minutes, yet the scoreboard all Buckeyes 19-0.
Draw play, Dustin Young, and he's still driving forward. He takes it out to midfield, just a gain of about one.
It was a nice job by Dustin to get any yardage on that before he's brought down number 36, Michael Simpson. They give credit to Wolf also, but Simpson's the one that actually drug him down as he was coming across the line that time.
Second and 14 for the Buckeyes. Just inside Chieftain territory. Nathan Dean out of the shotgun.
Chieftains had everybody within 4
yards
of the line of scrimmage.
Gets away from a would-be tackler, throws, and it falls incomplete, throwing it towards Garrison Breeze at the Logan 35.
That was a nice job by Nathan just to get rid of that ball with all that pressure around him, to be able to move and get over to the left side and find some open room just to get rid of that ball. Again, what I was starting to say, when the Buckeyes go to that spread offense, if you watch defensively for the Logan Chieftains, they're bringing that safety up, and they've got nobody 5 yards off the ball when the Buckeyes are spread out like this. Gives the Buckeyes a huge opportunity to put something downfield here.
Buckeyes third and 14 at midfield. 3 receivers this side, 2 to the far side. Pass coming to this side, and it falls incomplete down at the 33 of Logan.
Actually, Freer did a nice job that time of just going up and tipping that ball away. Nathan was under pressure again, number 15 that time. Jordan Sharb of the Chieftains came off that line and was in his face quickly. And Sharb's a big guy, senior, 6'2", 210. I'd say he looks a good 6'1", 6'2 out there. But he was able to get the pressure on Nathan, and as he put the ball up, Freer did a nice job of just tipping that away and not allowing it to be intercepted.
Lindsay and McCarty back deep for Logan. Dustin Young will punt it away for the Buckeyes. Nice snap.
It was the first time the
Chieftains. Nice punt by Dustin Young backing up McCarty, and it hit him. The ball's loose. It did hit him.
Oh, he picks it up in the end zone, luckily.
And they say that will be a touchback.
Wow, he hit the ball out at the 10-yard line, then it bounced off him and went back that way.
Of course, on a kickoff, that would be a touchback if you touch the ball outside and it went into the end zone in high school football. I guess I'm not sure on a receiving a punt.
That was one of the nicer punts the Buckeyes have had, though. That really did put some air underneath that ball. I was starting to say that was the first time that the Buckeyes offense was not able to march down and put some points on. The Chieftain defensively stood a little taller that time.
Two receivers to the far side. Logan first and 10 on their own 20. Music keeps it himself, and he'll pick up 2 out to the 22-yard line on the far side.
As Dakota Hook is one of the tacklers, but I don't know who else was over there. Obviously, there was a couple other Buckeyes involved. Again, just swarming to the ball as Music comes across the line. They're going to say Mello and Covert were over there also to help out Hook.
Second down and 8, Logan on their own 22. Receivers split out to each side. Music takes a snap, pitches out coming to this side. It's Lindsay for Logan. Buckeyes in pursuit, and he'll go down at the line of scrimmage.
Nice job by Covert to just nullify that play. The Buckeyes, not just was Covert out there, but Perkins and I forget who else, I apologize, was out that way, did a nice job of stretching that play out. Again, it's very hard to get outside with the Buckeyes.
No gain on the play. Brings up 3rd and 8, Logan on their own 22. Buckeyes hoping to hold here and get good field position for the offense.
Again, at this point, the Chieftains have had 4 different third down opportunities. They've only converted on one, and that was because the Buckeyes gave them a pass interference penalty.
Third and eight, Music rolls to the right side, looking to throw. He does have a man open momentarily. Lightwine knocks him out of bounds. He'll be a couple yards shy of a first down, actually about 3 yards shy.
There's number 33 on the catch, Sean Watring. Watring gets the ball out across the 25 there. But
about a 2.5 yards shy of a first down. Let's see what Logan elects to do. It looks like they will punt it away. Breeze and Lightwine back deep for the Buckeyes. I believe that's Aaron Wolf to punt it away for Logan. Nice snap. Gets it away. Nice high punt. Fair catch called for and made by Garrison Breeze at the Buckeye 40. Nice job by Garrison Breeze. You let that ball bounce, it might go another 20 or 30 yards.
And another nice job by the Buckeye defense to hold the Chieftain offense to, you know, three and out that time. That was the first time the Chieftains actually opted to punt the ball. They've been stopped on third down plenty of times, but they've opted to go for the fourth down three different times. This time they were deep enough in their territory after that beautiful kick by the Buckeyes to put him down there. They ended up deciding to kick it back over to the Buckeyes.
Buckeyes first and 10 on their own 41. 9.5 minutes to play before halftime. Buckeyes up 19-0. Austin North goes in motion to the far side. Handoff. Dustin Young finds some running room. And that's Clint Handel on the carry. He'll take it out to the 48.
It's brought down by number 7, and I believe it to be McCarty 24 back there along with the for the tackle.
7-yard pickup for Handel. Buckeyes with a 2nd and 3 on their own 48.
Again, the Buckeyes are showing the different types of weapons and options they have offensively out here tonight.
Two receivers to this side. Buckeyes out of the eye. Hand off Dustin Young up the middle, and he's got a Buckeye first down at the Logan 48. Pick up a 4.
McCarty and number 36 that time, Simpson on the stop, but you're right. Dustin Young busts right up the middle and gets another strong first down for the Buckeyes.
First and 10, Nelsonville York at the Chieftain 48. Daniel Klein will split out wide to this side. Nathan Dean at quarterback, pitch out. Dustin Young cuts it up, and he's tripped up, and he'll dive down to the Chieftain 45, a gain of about 3.
Again, I believe that was McCarty that came up and actually tripped him up before he was able to get too much head of steam going that time, but it looked like if he could have got past that trip, he might have been gone for quite a few strong yards.
Second and 7, Nelsonville York at the Logan 45. Austin North, Mark Carter goes in motion to the far side. Quick hitter. I believe that's Perkins this time. Still battling for yardage and takes it to the Logan 40-yard line.
Very nice hard run by Perkins that time as he was not going to give up. And he might have got inside the 40, close to the 39, about 6 yards on the carry. Simpson makes the tackle that time for the Chieftains. But, you know, this is where I was starting to talk about the different weapons the Buckeyes have. They've already passed the ball to 3 different receivers, and they've already had 4 different individuals carry the ball for the Buckeyes offensively here in the first half.
Buckeyes need another yard and a half for a first down. Ball spotted just inside the 40 of Logan. It is third down for Nelsonville York. Buckeyes out of the eye, 2 receivers to this side. Hand off Dustin Young. Through the middle, Dustin Young, 10, 5. Touchdown, Dustin Young.
Well, we were just talking about the fact that the Buckeyes have been able to score 3 touchdowns, and Dustin Young hadn't been able to put any points on the board, and next thing you know, on a third down situation, third and short, they just open up a hole. And again, once he's past the third 3 yards, 4 yards, there's nobody that's able to stop him because the middle is wide open. Dustin just shoots through there. He shows his speed off again right up the middle for 40 yards. Touchdown for the Buckeyes.
Buckeyes attempting the extra point. And the kick is up. And the kick is good. 7:09 to play. In the first half, the Buckeyes lead 26-0. Nathan Dean will kick it away for Nelsonville York. The approach and the kick coming to this side.
Nice kick.
And a bounce at the 12, taken by the Chieftains. Takes it back to the middle of the field, and the Buckeyes take him down at the 17.
Coverage team for the Buckeyes just did an excellent job that time of wrapping him up. Number 38 was actually the return man, Smeltzer, that time for the Chieftains. Gets the ball around the 12. Can't get just barely past the 15 to the 16, and the Buckeyes wrap him up.
Logan, first and 10 on their own 17-yard line. Jack Music at quarterback for the Chieftains. Two receivers to the far side. Handoff on the right side, and McCarty is cut down inside the 15 of loss of 2 yards.
Again, Dakota Hook shooting through there from his linebacker position, just takes the legs out from underneath McCarty before he can even get going.
Buckeyes up 26-0 over Logan with 6:45 to play in the second quarter. Of course, Nelsonville York coached by Dave Boston Jr. in his ninth year. Kelly Wolf, the head coach of Logan, in his second year. Chieftain second down and 12. Quick pass. It might be a lateral. And Watfring pulls it in, but he's taken down back inside
he
the
might
15,
end up,
right
might
around
end up,
the line of scrimmage.
He might end up with a yard loss on that, as Dakota Hook was very quick to get outside there.
And they will spot it back at the 13. That will be a yard loss. Brings up third and 13 for the Chieftains. .5:55 to play in the first half. Buckeyes leading by 26. Chieftains third down and 13 on their own 13. Music takes the snap. He's back to pass, rolls to this side, throws, and it falls incomplete. Good coverage.
Great coverage
Daniel
by Bobby
Klein.
Lightwine and Daniel Klein that time, as they messed that play up before it goes anywhere. You know, Music is only a sophomore quarterbacking there for the Chieftains back there, and definitely has him in a tough position.
Chieftains will punt it away on 4th and 13 from their own 13. Buckeyes looking to get
does make
great
you wonder
field position.
If the starting quarterback Kyle Grove has got injured or
Long.
Hurt somehow, or Long, I'm sorry, Kyle Long,
Kelly yeah. Long.
Kelly Long. I was looking at Kyle Grove. They're the wrong number there, number 16. But Music, you know, as a sophomore, is doing what he can back there. Buckeyes defensively are just all over the ball.
Low snap. He pulls it in nicely. Buckeyes nearly get it.
Low liner. Just run away from it.
And the Buckeyes will start in Chieftain territory at the 47-yard line. 5:29 to play before halftime. 26-0 Buckeyes. Buckeyes first and 10 at the Chieftain 47. Dean takes a snap, fake handoff, hands it off to North. And North breaks a couple tackles, and he'll take it to the Logan 37-yard line. That's a first down. He picks up about 10 and a half yards.
Nice spin move by North right at the line of scrimmage to bust himself into the middle of the line. And then, you know, that's just one of the things we were talking about. He's just in a very elusive type runner. He's one of those guys that he can move as quick left to right as he can forward, and just does a nice job of finding the holes.
First down Buckeyes at the Logan 36-yard line. Dean takes a snap, pitches it out. And that's Perkins, and he's taken down right around the line of scrimmage. It may be a yard loss for the Buckeyes. Good pursuit by the Chieftains that time.
Wesselhoff on the stop that time for the Chieftains defensively, as Perkins, like you said, gets stopped right at the line of scrimmage.
He's 6'2", 240.
I was noticing the last tackle was made by number 62 of the Chieftains, Caleb Branson. He's 6'1", 200, and only a sophomore. So you know that the sophomore class is the majority of the team for the Chieftains. They've got more sophomores than they do either juniors or seniors.
Second and 11, Young comes in motion to this side. Dean back to pass, quick slant, and it falls incomplete at the Logan 30.
Right through the arms of Daniel Klein, as he was looking to catch that and make a mad dash right through the middle of the field. He had some open green ahead of him. Had he been able to reel that one in.
Buckeyes third down and 11 at the Chieftain 37. 4:18 to play before halftime. The receivers split out on each side. Buckeyes out of the eye. Dean takes a snap, play action. Back to pass, throws over the middle. And let's see if he pulled it in. Nice catch. Kyle Freer, I believe.
Wow. It's going to look to be the spot of the ball here. Just depends where they put this ball, if that was enough for a first down. And we were just talking about Kyle Freer coming across the middle.
I'll tell you what, he really made some nice catches for the Buckeyes.
That's his signature play, coming across the middle and catching that ball. He does a nice job time and time again.
It's fourth down and about a foot to go for Nelsonville York. The Buckeyes, of course, will go for it at the Logan 27.
This is the first fourth down attempt for the Buckeyes. Like I mentioned, the Chieftains have had three different four down attempts, made one out of their three.
Handoff. Dustin Young bounced back going forward. It looks like he may have got the first down on that second and third effort.
I was going to say that. I don't think the second effort made it. The third was close, but the fourth effort is what put him over the edge that time. That was a great effort by Dustin Young individually to just keep driving and get that first down.
Dustin Young would not be denied. Looked like he was going to be dropped shy of the first down and puts in a lot of extra effort and picks up the first down for the Buckeyes. First and 10 at the Chieftain 25, 3:25 to play in the second quarter. Buckeyes up 26-0. Two receivers on each side. Freer goes in motion. Quick pass by Dean Polt. No, it's dropped by Austin North.
That's two quick slant passes, one to Daniel Klein on the left side, one to North on the right side. They just weren't able to handle the ball. You know, Nathan puts quite a bit of zip on that ball coming out. And when you're hitting that slant pass like that, you've got to be really ready for that catch.
I think both Klein and North saw end zone in their eyes.
Yeah.
When they were trying to pull that ball in. Buckeye second and 10 at the Chieftain 25. Mark Carter goes in motion to the left. Pitch out goes to Dustin Young. Young cuts it up, and he'll go down after a short gain, a pickup of a couple to the 23.
McCarty, number 24, makes the stop that time for the Chieftains.
Buckeyes third down and about seven. Of course, they are in Nathan Dean's range for a field goal. Right now it would be a 40-yarder, but Buckeyes, of course, hoping to get even a little closer than that. That would like to pick up the first down here on third down and about seven.
I was just going to say, if you're a Buckeye or a Buckeye fan, you'd like to see this go to the end zone.
Quick pass out to Daniel Klein, cuts it up the middle, and he'll dive down to about the 24-yard line. And the Buckeyes will have a fourth down and about four.
Brought down again by number seven, Friedley. And I believe 57 was in on the stop all there. Michael Forder that time for the Chieftains defensively.
Buckeyes will attempt the field goal now. Be about a 37, 38-yard attempt. Let's see where they spot it. It will be a 37-yard field goal. Perkins will snap. Young will hold. Dean will kick. And the kick is up. And the kick is good. Nathan Dean from 37 yards out. And the Buckeyes lead 29-0, 1:49 to play in the first half. Nathan Dean will kick it away for Nelsonville York. The approach and the kick taken by an up man at the 23-yard line. And he's upended. That was Nick Cost that took it to the far side for the Chieftains.
Just a sophomore for the Chieftains. It looked like number 24, Devin, or 44, I'm sorry, 44, Lightwine. And Dylan Cheeseman also on the stop over there for the Buckeyes coverage team. The Buckeyes coverage team, it's a different player every time making the hit or making the stop. They just have a great ability to get downfield, find the ball, and put a stop on it quickly.
First and 10 for the Chieftains. They have 1:44 left to work with here in the first half. Handoff goes to the tailback, and the Buckeyes all over it. But McCarty, nice effort by McCarty. He'll pick up five. It looks like he He was only going to pick up 1 yard.
I tell you what, McCarty did a nice job that time. It was just really sucking up behind his blockers, and he was unable, they couldn't grab him because they couldn't get around the blockers, and once they pushed them out of the way, he was able to fall forward for a few positive yards that time.
Second down and 5 for the Chieftains on their own 38. Clock at 1:14 to play here in the second quarter.
They stay in that power eye position.
Buckeyes with a lot of people in the box. Logan showing that power formation and pick up close to a first down. It looks like Logan does have it on about a 5-yard pickup. It was Corey McCarty once again.
They give the tackle to the interior defensive line of the Buckeyes. As, you know, I'm not sure you just say interior because I think we had 9 guys, maybe 10, right within 2 yards of the line of scrimmage that time.
First down, Chieftains. Hand off to McCarty. And he'll take it out to the 46-yard line, a gain of 3. And now the Chieftains will take one of their timeouts.
I believe Zach Mays and Isaiah McCombs that time on the stop for the Buckeyes.
43 seconds to play in the first half. Nelsonville York 29, Logan 0. Chieftains second down and about 7. On their own 46, pitch out goes to McCarty on the far side.
We're going to say he stepped out of bounds.
Right around the 49, maybe right at midfield. Let's see where they spot it. Chieftains will need 3 yards for a first down. 37 seconds to play in the first half. Third down and 3.
This will be the 7th third down opportunity for the Chieftains offensively.
Pitch out goes to McCarty. And McCarty taken down. It looks like he has the first down for Logan, but that's about it. Takes it to the Buckeye 47-yard line.
And that'll actually be the first time that the offense of the Chieftains were able to grab that first down on a third down opportunity. The only other time they got a first down on a third down was with a penalty against the Buckeyes on a pass interference. So 2 out of 7 for the third down conversions for the Chieftains offense, and that's all because the Buckeyes defensively are just all over the ball.
It is a first down for Logan. They call timeout. 29-0 Buckeyes, 30 seconds to play in the first half. Chieftains will go out of the shotgun, a receiver on each side. Music throwing long on the right side. And Breeze pulls it in. A flag comes in. And let's see what the call is. Again, a flag is down.
Well, Garrison Breeze read that right from the beginning. You could see as soon as that ball was in the air, he had the best chance to catch it. But that flag was thrown typically in the area of pass interference.
Pass interference on Nelsonville York. So that'll wipe out the interception and will be a 15-yard mark off on Nelsonville York from the line of scrimmage. Chieftains will have a first down.
Well, I don't know. Breeze goes up to get that ball. I don't know if it matters if there's a pass interference or not. He's the one that came down with the ball and was not involved in the pass interference.
Ball will be spotted at the Nelsonville York 32. Logan with 21 seconds left before half. They do have one timeout remaining.
So that's 2 huge pass interference penalties against the Buckeyes to help out the Chieftain offense.
Music takes a snap. He'll throw long on the right side again. Breeze once again. And this time it falls incomplete as Breeze knocks it down inside the Buckeye 10.
Actually, I think North knocked it out of Breeze's hands that time. But either way, the Buckeyes were all over that. Both Breeze and North back there covering. It looked to be the exact same play we saw on the last down for the Chieftains.
15.6 seconds to play before halftime. 2nd and 10, Logan at the Buckeye 32. Buckeyes up 29-0. Music out of the shotgun, a receiver on each side. Music throwing long to this side this time. And it's nearly intercepted by Daniel Klein, but it falls incomplete at the 10-yard line.
Well, that's 3 passes in a row that have hit Buckeye's hands and haven't come close to a Chieftain's hands yet. And Daniel would love to have that one back, I'm sure. He was sitting waiting on that ball getting there.
Chieftains with 10.3 seconds to play in the second quarter.
Well, Buckeyes defensively keep giving them an extra chance here, but they also are doing a great job on the defensive coverage.
Logan will take their final timeout. They have a third and 10 at the Buckeye 32. 10.3 seconds to play in the first half. Third and 10 Chieftains at the Buckeye 32. Music takes the snap out of the shotgun, being rushed, and he's sacked back at the 37. The ball was loose, but they said he was down. And Logan out of timeouts. The clock will run out here in the first half.
Coon and Covert put the tackle on to stop that last opportunity for the Chieftains offense.
Great first half for Nelsonville York. At halftime, it's the Buckeyes 29, the Chieftains nothing.
Logan High School proudly presents the 2011 Marching in Rhythm, Moving in Style, Logan Marching Chieftains. This is evening show is under the direction of Mrs. Pam Price. And our second halftime show of the season is a tribute to the Fab Four of the Beatles. The Marching Chieftains take the field with I Wanna Hold Your Hand. K's Hour Concert Hall Sound. The Marching Chieftains close this evening show with a beautiful arrangement featuring junior trumpeter Mariah Light. This is Let It Be and Me Too.
Thank you.
back here at Boston Field to start the second half. The Buckeyes have the 29-0 lead against the Chieftains.
Nathan Beam with the kickoff to begin the second half. A short kick coming to this side, taken by Lindsay, crosses the 20. And Lindsay held up a little bit by light line, and then the Buckeyes make the tackle.
Dakota Hook finally brings him down as he gets her out to the 40-yard line that time. Well, the Logan Chieftains coming out this second half trying to put a little more offensive threat against the Buckeyes. Defensively, the Buckeyes just played great. The Logan Chieftains in the first half carried the ball 19 times for a total of 49 yards. McCarty had the most of those, 14 carries for 44. Passing the ball, Music actually put the ball in the air 9 times, 4 completions for 10 yards. Total of 59 offensive yards for the Chieftains in the first half.
Kelly Long now quarterback out of the shotgun for Logan. Takes a snap, runs to this side, and the Buckeye's right there. And he'll go down at the line of scrimmage. May have been a loss of about a half yard.
Daniel Klein the first to hit him and then brought down by Kyle Moore. Nice job by the Buckeyes defensively yet again.
Kelly Long has rushed for 68 yards for the Chieftains and a couple touchdowns on the season so far. Second and 11, Logan on their own 39. Buckeyes up 29-0 as we begin the second half. Three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Long takes a snap, and he throws over the middle and nearly picked off by the Buckeyes.
That was tipped right at the line of scrimmage, and then Covert almost intercepted that ball. But again, you know, the Buckeyes have a lot of height along the front, you know, especially when they put Kyle Moore on the inside. They've got both Daniel Klein, Kyle Moore, Isaiah Mello all along the line. You got a lot of height that makes it opposing for the offensive line and the quarterback of the opposition. There's another third and long here for the Chieftain offensively.
Third down and 11 for Logan on their own 39. Three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Kelly Long out of the shotgun. Takes a snap.
Kyle Moore's in
and
there.
And he gets away from a would-be tackler.
The flag does come in.
We may have holding on the Chieftains. And Long will go down after a gain of 5 out to the 45.
Looks like Jacob Perkins comes up and makes the stop, but you're right, that flag is going to back him up.
Holding on the Chieftains.
That'll give him a second third down opportunity as that'll.
The Buckeyes may decline.
that would bring up
4th and 5 if they decline. It's a decision for Nelsonville York.
Coach wants 4th. You can see Boston on the sideline giving him the.
I think they're asking where would the penalty be marked off from. Holding on Logan, and it is decline. That'll bring up 4th and 5 for the Chieftains.
Again, the Chieftains offensively in the first half had 8 third down opportunities, converted on 2 of them, one on their own, one on a defensive penalty from the Buckeyes. Here's their first third down opportunity in the second half, and the Buckeyes defense shuts them down again.
Logan will punt it away. Nick Cost will punt it away for Logan. Garrison Breeze back deep for the Buckeyes. And it's a fake. McCarty with the football, and he's got the first down.
Bobby
McCarty
Lightline
on the far side breaks another tackle. Corey McCarty. And let's see, is he in? He may be just shy of the first down.
I think that was number 57, Austin McCullough, coming off the line to run him down inside the 5-yard line that time. Great pursuit.
So Logan trying to get a little spark, fake a punt on 4th and 5, and not only do they pick up the first down, they're going to have a 1st and goal at the Buckeye 2. 10:26 to play in the third quarter. The Buckeyes up 29-0.
Nick Cost did a nice job of selling that for the Chieftains offensively with the punter that time. Oh, the Buckeyes jump off sides.
That might be 1st and goal at the 1 after the offside mark off. Chieftains will go with a power package.
Quickly to the line,
handoff. And in for the touchdown is Corey McCarty from 1 yard out. And the Chieftains are on the scoreboard.
Well, you can see the difference in the offensive strategy for the Chieftains coming out here in the second half. It's all or nothing. They're down 29-0. They figure they're going to go for anything to be able to get whatever yardage they can get. And if they need trick plays, if they need to do things a little differently than conventional, they're going to have to do it here in the second half.
Chieftains going for two. Long takes the snap, rolls right, being pressured, throws, and it's picked off in the end zone, so the two-point conversion attempt fails.
Nice job by Perkins back there on the coverage to come away with that interception on the two-point conversion.
10:22 to play, third quarter. Buckeyes lead 29-6. Buckeyes with Austin North, Garrison Breeze, Dustin Young back deep.
Time to see if the Buckeyes offense can come out and pick up where they were at in the first half and march back down and match that score of the Chieftains here in the second half.
Nick Koss kicks it away, a little squib kick up the field taken by North. Takes it up the middle of the field. North across the 40. And he'll go down right around the 41-yard line. That's where the Buckeyes will have their first possession of the second half.
Number 50, Alex Schneider makes the stop that time for the Chieftains. And you're right, at the 40-yard line, the Buckeyes get the ball. And, you know, at this point, the Buckeyes saw what the Chieftains are coming out. The Chieftains are going to, you know, give it everything they have here in the second half. So the Buckeyes cannot let up. They've got their junior quarterback in for the Chieftains here in the second half. And the Buckeyes offensively just need to pick up where they were in the first half and keep going.
Buckeyes out of the eye, and Dustin Young hit for a loss.
56 that time. Paul Wesselhoff just comes flying in there and puts the stop for probably a three-yard loss that time against Dustin. You know, Dustin in the first half carried the ball 13 times for 125 yards. Overall, the Buckeyes had the ball 19 carries for 194 yards, and Nathan was 5 of 9 in the air for 69 yards, a total of 263 yards in the first half for the Buckeyes offense.
Buckeyes out of the eye once again on second and 12 from their own 38. Austin North goes in motion left. Draw play goes to Dustin Young. And Dustin Young will go down after a gain of 1 to the 39. It brings up third and 11.
Again, number 50 on the stop that time, Alex Schneider for the Chieftains. And you can see after that touchdown, the enthusiasm level of the defense of the Chieftains have picked up, and emotions are such a huge part of high school football. When you've got high school football players, you're talking, you know, these guys are 16, 17, 18 years old. Their emotions can be swung one way or another very easily. And right now, the emotions in the Chieftains, they've got a little feeling like they've got an opportunity to come back here in the second half.
Buckeyes out of the shotgun. Dean takes a snap, looking to throw. Throws long over the middle, and it falls incomplete at the Logan 35-yard line.
In and out of the hands that time of Breeze as he was open, as he got a few yards on his defensive man that time.
So the Buckeyes will have to punt it away on fourth and 11. .856 to play in the third quarter. Buckeyes lead by 23. Dustin Young will punt it away for Nelsonville York. Jacob Perkins will snap. I believe it's Isaac Lindsay back deep for Logan. Young gets it away.
Great kick.
Nice kick by Young. Backs Lindsay to his 17. Now he takes it back to the other side of the field. Trying to cut it up to the middle, but he's dropped right at the 25. Good coverage by Nelsonville York. Nice punt by Dustin Young.
They say Bobby Lightwine made the hit, but there was like five Buckeyes that swarmed to him as he was trying to make his way to the outside. It looked to me like Zach Mays cut that outside off and didn't allow him to get around the corner. He tries to cut back inside, and the Buckeyes were right there to clean things up. Buckeyes defense now has to stand a little strong right here. They did a nice job at the first part of that series. Gave up the fake punt that put the Chieftains in position to score that last series. Be nice to see if they can stop him on a three and out right here.
Logan with the receiver on each side. First and 10 from their own 25, and a right end moved. Illegal procedure on the Chieftains.
Referees got a little bit of help from some of the Buckeyes defensively, pointing to the man at fault that time. Five-yard
First and 15, Logan. Just outside their own 20. Long at quarterback. Looking to pass, throwing long to this side.
Wow.
And it is pulled in by Isaac Lindsay at the Buckeye 40-yard line.
That was a great catch by Lindsay as it went over the opposite shoulder. He was turned one way, came back around the other way, and just made an excellent catch as it was just over the hands of defensively Breeze and Perkins out here on this side. Again, though, that ball was in the air, a solid 40 yards. Nice throw that time for the Chieftains.
Kelly Long on that pass for Logan. Chieftains first and 10 at the Buckeye 41.
And in the first two series, the Chieftains already have more yards here in the second half than they had in the entire first half.
Two receivers to the right, one to the left. McCarty at tailback. Long takes a snap, and he tries to throw quickly. And it's an incomplete pass as he's hit as he was releasing the football.
Wow, Buckeye defense just blitzed everybody that time. They just brought the house, as you say, and he didn't even have time on a three-step drop to get rid of that ball because that was a design play to get that ball out of his hands quickly. Just wasn't quick enough.
Caleb Covert applying the pressure. Second down and 10 for Logan at the Buckeye 41. And we have a timeout taken by the Chieftains. 8:09 to play, third quarter, 29-6 Buckeyes. Logan, second down and 10 at the Nelsonville York 41. Kelly Long out of the shotgun. Two receivers on each side. And he will hand it off to Corey McCarty, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line, a gain of about five.
Covert did a nice job that time. If it wasn't for Covert, that would have been a first down. They did a nice job of spreading the field and forcing the defense of the Buckeyes to cover the entire sideline to sideline and then try to run McCarty right up the middle.
Third down and five for Logan. At the Buckeye 35. Three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Kelly Long out of the shotgun. Takes a snap, he will run it on the right side, and Long's got the first down and more as he takes it to the Buckeye 24-yard line, picks up about 11.
He did a nice job of following McCarty as the lead blocker that time over the right-hand side, and he gets inside the 25, like you said, down to the 24 before Bobby Lightwine and Klein were able to bring him down.
Officials timeout. I don't know what's going on. The entire Logan team going over towards the sideline. It was an officials timeout.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I'm not sure that the entire team's allowed to go talk to the coach if there's an equipment issue for one kid, but that's what they were able to do for some reason. Again, you know, we get to this passing game here. You can already see how slow the game has gone. We've still got 7:20 to go here in the third quarter as the Chieftains now moving the ball in the air, which stops the clock a lot more throughout the second half here. And you can start to see a little bit of rain coming down here now, Jim.
Long takes a snap, throws quickly to this side. It is pulled in by Whatring.
Brought down by Daniel Klein as he gets inside the 20.
Pickup of about seven. Sean Whatring on the reception. Be second and three at the Buckeye 17-yard line.
You can definitely see a difference in the experience with Kelly Long in the backfield directing traffic for this Chieftain offense.
Long keeps it himself, and he's going to be hit and dropped right around the line of scrimmage.
Again, right shooting through there is Dakota Hook, along with Kyle Moore on the stop that time for the Buckeyes.
That was a loss of about a half yard on the play, still caught third and three. Ball resting at the Buckeye 17-yard line. Third down and three for Logan. Three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Kelly Long out of the shotgun for Logan. Takes a snap, being rushed, throws a slant, and it is caught inside the Buckeye 10 at the 9. That is a first down, and Logan will have a first and goal.
He's brought down immediately by Perkins, but the receiver that time for the Chieftains did a nice job of sealing Perkins behind him and keeping, almost like playing a pick play in basketball, keeping himself between the ball and the quarterback and allowing that pass to get in there.
5.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. 29-6, Buckeyes, Chieftains driving, first and goal at the Buckeye 9. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. And a flag comes in.
I think they got the Buckeyes jumping again.
Offsides on Nelsonville York is the call. Half the distance to the goal. First and goal inside the Buckeye 5. Kelly Long out of the shotgun. Low snap. And the ball carrier will go down for a loss. The ball still loose. Ground. And let's see what the call is. They're saying the ball carrier was down for Logan at the 7-yard line.
You know, that's one of those situations. I think he might have been down, but the whistle was so late. The kids got to keep playing until the whistle. You know, that's what you're taught from third grade on, is you play until the whistle hits. And that whistle was never blowing. The Buckeyes thought they had that one.
Second and goal, Chieftains at the Buckeye 7. Logan will go to the power eye. And let's see it once again. Movement on the line. Let's see if it's offsides on the Buckeyes once again. And it is offsides on Nelsonville York. That ball will be spotted at the 4. It'll be second and goal for the Chieftains. So Kelly Long going with that hard count. Chieftains rush to the line of scrimmage in the power eye. Handoff goes to McCarty, and he's stopped shy of the goal line. Looks like he got inside the 1, however, to bring up third and goal for Logan.
Well, he was real close to getting into that goal line that time. Dakota Hook and Zach Mays on the stop that time for the Buckeyes. Well, that ball is inside the 1-yard line now with a third and real short.
Once again, the power package for the Chieftains. And a quick snap, the ball loose. Flags come in. Legal procedure on Logan.
Yeah, that's got to go against the Chieftains that time.
So it's spotted back at the 6, where it's third and goal from the 6.
Well, it's a lot nicer to see that ball back at the 6-yard line than inside the 1, Jim.
Third and goal at the Buckeye 6.
Now the Buckeyes just have to be disciplined here and not jump off sides like they've done here in consistent.
Long out of the shotgun, takes a snap, low snap, throws towards the end zone, and it's incomplete. It looked like Isaac Lindsay, the intended receiver.
Mello did a nice job coming off the defensive end that time for the Buckeyes and jumping up again with his long arms, forcing Long to throw that ball way higher than I think he intended to, or getting rid of it a little quicker than he wanted to. Either way, puts up a fourth down situation that the Chieftains are probably going to go for.
I don't believe Logan has attempted a field goal this year so far. Fourth down and 6. And Logan will call their second timeout of the half. 3:18 to play, third quarter, 29-6, Buckeyes. Fourth and goal at the Buckeye 6. Logan out of the power eye. Kelly Long at quarterback. He's rolling, looking to throw, being pressured, and he'll go down. It's a sack for the Buckeyes. Dakota Hook in there.
Dakota Hook and Isaiah Mello get the pressure on him. He tries to cut back across the field and just goes down. Huge fourth down stop for the Buckeyes defense. here in the second half.
They had a third and goal inside the Buckeye one. And Nelsonville York holds on downs.
Gets the turnover. Not only do they get the turnover on downs, they get the ball outside the 10, where they get a little bit of breathing room instead of getting the ball down there at the 1 yard line. So they're out their own 11 yard line here. Much better position than down inside your own one. But the Buckeyes defense holds very strong there. Great showing.
Actually, it's even better. Buckeyes on their own 16.
Oh, it is.
Carter goes in motion. Buckeyes with the sack on the previous play. Hand off to Dustin Young. And he's going to go down after a short gain. It looked like he got it to the 17, and that's about it. So the Chieftains have tightened it up a little bit defensively.
Yeah, they've definitely come out here in the second half, and you can see him keying in on Dustin. You know, Dustin, because there were so many other kids that were active in the first half, Dustin didn't seem like he had a ton of carries, but he still had 13 carries for 125 yards in his first half. And they've made a decision to shut him down here in the second half.
Second and nine, handoff Dustin Young. And he'll cross the 20 and get it close to the 21, and the Buckeyes will be facing a third down and about six.
Wesselhoff that time in for the defensive side of the ball for the Chieftains.
2:18 to play in the third quarter. Buckeyes leading by 23.
Again, you can see the difference in the defense for the Chieftains. Knowing that they seem to have a little bit more of an offensive threat, their defense has a little more leg and pep underneath their step also.
Quick slant, and it's incomplete. Intended for Daniel Klein, and the Buckeyes will have to punt it away.
So that's the second series here in the second half for the Buckeyes. Both three and out this time for the Buckeyes in the third quarter.
Isaac Lindsay back deep to receive the punt for Logan. Dustin Young has hit a couple good punts for the Buckeyes in this game. I think the last one went about 44 yards in the air.
Yeah, this will be one that will give the Chieftains pretty decent field position.
This one a little bit
maybe
shorter.
Better than we think.
And it takes a Logan bounce. Buckeyes will down it at the 35-yard line of Nelsonville York. Look like Buckeyes may have touched it out at the 40, so that's where Logan will have it. 1:50 to play in the third quarter, and the Buckeyes lead 29-6. Kelly Long out of the shotgun for the Chieftains. Two receivers on each side. McCarty in the backfield. Low snap. Ball loose.
Ball's on the ground.
Still
loose. Nobody sees it.
And
Buckeyes got it.
Buckeyes.
No, nobody's got it yet.
Buckeyes claim they have it, but let's see if the officials agree. And they do. Jacob Kuhn comes away with it.
Jacob Kuhn comes up with the ball. Nobody even knew the ball was on the ground to begin with. It squirted out there, and everybody was just going on with the play. Then all of a sudden, I thought we jumped on it the first time. It squirted away from us, and then it squirted away from them, and then Kuhn comes up with it for the Buckeyes. Huge turnover for the Buckeyes here in the second half.
And the Buckeyes will have it at the Logan 49. 1:40 to play in the third quarter. Buckeyes up 23.
And that's the third turnover in favor of the Buckeyes here this evening.
Two receivers to this side, one to the far side. Dean out of the shotgun. Takes the snap, looking to throw. Going to throw long.
Daniel.
Daniel Klein. And it falls incomplete.
Whoa.
And a flag comes in. And it looks like we're going to have pass interference on the Chieftains.
If they call it against the defense, hopefully they don't call it against the offense.
And let's see what the call is. Pass interference, and it is on Nelsonville York.
I was afraid of that. Just the way that looked with Daniel behind the play that time, I was afraid they were calling that against the Buckeyes that time.
When I thought it was going to be on Logan, I thought I didn't agree with that call. It looked like very good coverage by the Chieftains, and it is on Nelsonville York. That will be a loss of down. 15-yard penalty. That's a big penalty in high school football. 15-yard penalty and loss of down.
Yeah, it doesn't get much worse than that in high school ball.
Buckeyes, four receivers split out to this side. Dean out of the shotgun. He'll throw to Klein. Daniel Klein has some running room, crosses the 40, and takes it out to the 48-yard line.
Did you see the blocking that time by the other receivers? Austin North did an exceptional job along with Perkins out there. And I didn't catch the other individual. I apologize, but they just did a nice job.
Buckeyes pick up 13.
Shoving guys around that time to give him an opportunity to get some yardage.
Makes it a manageable third down here. Still long, third down and 12.
This will be the third down opportunity for the Buckeyes here in the second half. They have been unable to convert the first two. This will be the longest of them at third and 12.
Play clock down to 4 seconds. Freer in motion. Buckeyes just get it off. Quick slant north.
He couldn't hold on to it.
No, it's incomplete. Good coverage once again by Sean Watring. So the Buckeyes will punt it away on fourth and 12 on their own 49 with 40 seconds to play in the third quarter. Buckeyes up 23. Once again, Isaac Lindsay back deep for the Chieftains. Dustin Young will punt it away for the Buckeyes. Another nice snap, and a flag comes in. The play is dead. Legal procedure on Nelsonville York.
Penalties have definitely hurt the Buckeyes here in the second half, both offensively and defensively, allowing the Chieftains to get good field position and continue to be able to move the ball at times.
Fourth and 17, Buckeyes on their own 44, back deep, Corey McCarty and Isaac Lindsay. Dustin Young gets it away. Bounces at the Logan 26, takes a Buckeye bounce and roll, still rolling inside the 15. And that's where the Buckeyes will down it. So an effective punt by Dustin Young. Good coverage once again by Nelsonville York.
Well, you know, here's the situation. We've only got 26 seconds to go here in the third quarter. The Buckeyes dominated the first half, 29-0 at halftime. It's 29-6. The rain is starting to come down a little bit heavier now. Hopefully that has a little bit more of effect on Long and his passing game. But the Buckeyes offensively have had a real tough time here in the second half. The defense of the Chieftains has really stepped their game up and come out much more aggressively. Buckeyes only have 14 positive yards in the second half.
Kelly Long out of the shotgun. He hands it off to Corey McCarty. Comes to this side. A flag comes in. We probably have holding on the Chiefs.
Yeah, there was holding against Perkins on the corner that time as he was trying to shed the blocker, and the blocker was holding him away from getting his tackle. Nice call by the ref that time. He's right on top of the play.
Holding on Logan. 19 seconds to play in the third quarter.
So I just make the comment that the penalties were hurting the Buckeyes here in the second half, and the Chieftains come out in this drive here and start the very first playoff with a big penalty against themselves to back themselves up again. They started out with the ball down on the 13. This is going to put the ball inside the 10.
Penalty from the spot of the foul, and they'll put the ball on the 9-yard line of Logan, where it'll be first down and about 14. Chieftains, three receivers to the right, one to this side. Kelly Long with that hard count, but the Buckeyes not biting this time. Long keeps it himself on the right side, and the Buckeyes right there.
Number 57, Austin McCullough in there that time for the stop, along with Hook coming in and helping out.
He picks up one to the 10. It'll bring up second and 13. That was the final play of the third quarter. And after three at Boston Field, the Buckeyes lead the Chieftains 29-6. Second down and 13, Logan on their own 10 as we begin the final 12 minutes here at Boston Field. Long out of the shotgun. Rolls to the far side, throws, and it is complete out to the 24-yard line. And that will be a first down for Logan. Gain of about 13.
Number 10 on the reception. Yet again, Isaac Lindsay for the Chieftains.
First down and 10, Logan on their own 25-yard line. Chieftains splitting out a receiver to the far side, three to this side. Kelly Long out of the shotgun, and he'll keep it himself on a quarterback draw, and the Buckeyes standing up after a gain of about three out to the 27, where to bring up second and 7.
Again, I'm not sure who to give credit to that tackle. The entire defensive line for the Buckeyes did a nice job of stopping him on that side over there.
27-yard line.
Second down and seven. Chieftains on their own 27. We've played 1 minute here in the fourth quarter at Boston Field. Again, the Buckeyes lead by 23. Three receivers to this side, one to the far side. A flag comes in. Legal procedure, I believe, on Logan, and that is the call.
That'll back them up. Again, you know, just penalties on both sides of the ball here in the second half. Which again stops the clock, and that's not something the Buckeyes really want to do in this game. They want that clock to start running.
So now it'll be second down and 12 for the Chieftains. Back on their own 23-yard line. Again, three receivers to this side, one to the far side. Kelly Long out of the shotgun for Logan. The snap looked to bounce to him, and he's going to be taken down in the backfield. That will be a loss for the Chieftains, back close to the 20. Loss of two.
First hit by McCullough, and then Caleb Covert, as he spun away from Austin, Covert comes in and wraps him up, along with Kuhn and some others back there to back him up. But you're right, that ball was snapped on the ground that time.
Brings up third down and about 14 for Logan on their own 21-yard line.
Seems like he's trying that hard count just about every time he goes to the line to try to pull that Buckeye defensive line off sides again.
Long takes a snap, looking on the far side. He pulls it down. He'll run with it. And he will go down. The ball pops out, but they said he was down. But it will bring up fourth down for Logan. Fourth down and about nine as he picks up 5 yards.
McCullough and Hook on the stop, teaming up again that time for the Buckeyes defensively. But again, that ball seemed to come out before the whistle. Now, he did call him down, but it's one of those things that the whistle just slightly behind the play at times.
Logan looks to be punting again. They faked one earlier on a fourth and five. This is fourth and nine. Nice snap, and it is punted away. Buckeyes will let it bounce on their own 41, and that's where Logan will down it. The Buckeyes will have it with 9:03 to play in the third quarter, 29-6, Nelsonville York. Buckeyes out of the eye, two receivers to the far side. Hand off Dustin Young up the middle. Dustin Young with some running room, and he'll pick up about 11 yards to the 48 of Logan.
Brought down by number 36, Michael Simpson that time. That's going to be enough for a first down. Nice job by Dustin Young. And, you know, we were just talking about the fact that the Buckeyes have had the ball three times here in the second half, a total of somewhere in the neighborhood of 14 yards. And then Dustin bust one there that time for a nice 11-yard run. See if the Buckeyes can put a nice drive together and put some more points on the board here in the second half.
Buckeyes out of the eye once again. Dustin Young running room, but he will be taken down from behind. Nice tackle by the Chieftains, Corey McCarty.
Yeah, McCarty's just been all over the board for the Chieftains, both offensively and defensively, doing a nice job. But again, that was a nice hole by the offensive line of the Buckeyes to give Dustin that room, and he busts through, gets a solid 8 yards on that carry.
Second and two for Nelsonville York at the Chieftain 40. Buckeyes out of the eye. Perkins at fullback now. Hand off Dustin Young. And he'll go down right around the 36-yard line of the Chieftains as he picks up four.
Well, that's three plays in a row, the exact same play. And the Buckeyes have got positive yardage each and every time, 11, 8, 4. Nice job by the Buckeyes again, keeping the ball on the ground, keeping the ball in Dustin's hands, and running that clock out, trying to drive this ball down. They're down at close to the 35 now.
First and 10, handoff goes to Clint Handa, and he'll take it to the 33-yard line on a gain of three. Handa came into this game with 122 yards rushing for the Buckeyes and a couple touchdowns. Dustin Young, of course, around 800 yards rushing after the first four games of the season on just 56 carries.
Jordan Sharp on the stop that time for the Chieftains. But as you can say, as you said, the Buckeyes are content now to just continue to run the ball. They've got more than just Dustin. As you can see, Clint Handa is a very effective runner for the Buckeyes and has been.
Dustin Young, another nice run, still going, and he'll take it down to the 20 as he'll pick up about 15 yards.
Well, like I said, in the first three series here in the second half, the Chieftain defense found a way to really shut the Buckeyes down. the Buckeyes revert back to nothing more than power running here in the fourth series of the fourth or the second half. And they're just running the ball extremely effectively now down all the way to the 20-yard line.
Buckeyes, two receivers to the right. Out of the I formation, Nathan Dean at quarterback. Handoff, Dustin Young comes to this side. Dustin Young breaks a tackle. And he'll take it down about the 11, maybe 12-yard lines where they'll spot it, a gain of 8.
Give the stop that time to number 62, Caleb Branson. But that time it looked like Dustin was going to get dropped for maybe a 1, possibly a 2-yard gain, and instead Dustin does a nice job of shedding that first tackler and cutting back inside, finding a little seam and getting some 8 positive yards for the Buckeye offense.
Second down and 2 for Nelsonville York at the 12 of the Chieftains. Buckeyes in a T formation. Handoff comes to this side. And down to about the 2-yard line is Austin North for the Buckeyes.
Boy,
just inside the 3.
Austin North did just a great job of following his lead blocker that time, Clint Handa. He just put his hand on his back and followed him all the way inside the 5 before anybody was able to even hit him that time.
6:18 to play in the fourth quarter. Buckeyes up 29-6. And it's first and goal. Nelsonville York inside the Logan 3. Buckeyes in a power package. Perkins, and I believe it's Carter, and Young in the backfield. Handoff, Dustin Young takes it to the middle, and he's in, I believe.
Look like
it. Still waiting for the signal. And they say he was down before reaching the goal line. So it'll be second and goal from about the 1-foot line.
Looked like he was almost like 2 yards into the end zone to me. Tough angle we've got here, I guess.
Buckeyes once again in the power eye. Dean at quarterback. He'll hand to Young on the right side, and he'll go down for a loss this time. Back to the 1-yard line. Third and goal for the Buckeyes, but in the meantime, the clock ticking at 5:12 remaining in this game, and the Buckeyes leading by 23.
I was just going to make that same comment that Buckeyes took this series over with over 8 minutes to go, almost 8 and a half, I believe. I don't remember exactly. We've already down to 5 minutes. They've been able to eat 3 minutes off the clock. More importantly, they're keeping the Chieftains' offense off the field, and not giving them a chance to come back in this ball game.
Buckeyes in a T formation. Now Young goes in motion to the right. Pitch out, and it's a touchdown for Nelsonville York.
Austin North gets the pitch that time for a 2-yard touchdown run, and Austin North has carried the ball 4 times here in the ball game and has 2 touchdowns. Nice productivity for Austin here tonight as the Buckeyes put some more points up on the board here in the second half.
And that's pretty much a game-clinching touchdown for Nelsonville York. Logan was down by 3 scores, but of course this makes it a 4-score game with just 4:44 to play. Buckeyes will attempt the point after touchdown. Perkins to snap, Young to hold, Dean to kick. And the kick is up and it's no good, off to the left. But the Buckeyes lead 35-6 with 4:44 to play. Nathan Dean will kick it away for Nelsonville York.
You know, and as you were saying, Jim, not only did the Buckeyes do a nice job of putting some more points on the board, which might be the clincher here in the fourth quarter, but they just took about 4 minutes off the clock on that drive also.
Little squib kick up the field. Good strategy by the Buckeyes. You don't want to kick it deep and risk a long return. The late flag comes in.
I believe that was against Chieftains there, taking a late hit on Inman of the Buckeyes. It'll be, my guess is, a penalty against the Chieftains.
Tell you what, you could late hit him all night and you wouldn't hurt him.
He's not going to stop coming at you, that's for sure. Apologize, I didn't catch you. I made the actual tackle that time for the Buckeyes. I heard him mention Cody Walker's name. It seems like there was a couple Buckeyes out there, but again, a big penalty against the Chieftains. Bat marches it back behind the 25-yard line with just 4 minutes and 40 seconds to go here in the ball game.
Personal foul on Logan. Ball spotted back at the Chieftain 24. Long takes a snap, hands it off to McCarty, and he's ball is loose. Buckeyes claim they have it, and they do.
This time Hook comes out of there with it. I don't know who made the initial hit, but they just drove in there and just knocked that ball loose instantly.
What a hit it was.
It was a massive hit.
The running back got knocked backwards.
And that's the fourth turnover against this Chieftain offense.
First down, Buckeyes at the Chieftain 23. 4.5 minutes to play in the game. Buckeyes up 35-6. Two receivers to the right for the Buckeyes. And a timeout will be taken by the Buckeyes. The play clock was down to 2 seconds. 4:34 to play in the game. 35-6, Nelsonville York. Buckeyes first and 10 at the Logan 23. Pitch out comes to this side. And Dustin Young will go down. A flag comes in. I'm not sure if we could have a face mask on the Chieftains.
I believe it was. Alex Schneider, number 50, made the tackle that time, but as Dustin rolled, he might have rolled into somebody. Reaching out, might have grabbed a face mask. We'll find out for sure. No.
No, it's a chop block on the Buckeyes.
Wow.
Illegal block on Nelsonville York. Of course, the Chieftains will take it. The Buckeyes picked up about 4.5 yards on the play. Buckeyes will go to 5-0 on the season, and of course they begin league play next week right here at Boston Field against the Wellston Golden Rockets.
Well, you know, we talked about it earlier in the season. You know, there's obviously one of the major goals of the Nelsonville York Buckeye program year in and year out is to win the Ohio division of the TVC. And, you know, nothing they've done to this point even goes towards that goal. So that starts next week against Wellston.
Dean out of the shotgun, he throws, and it is caught
Tip
by Daniel
caught.
Klein, and he'll take it in for a touchdown.
38 goes up and tips that ball, Schmelzer for the Chieftains, and then turns around, and Daniel just did a great job of keeping his eye on the ball, catches it, and goes in for a touchdown. Now, back at the point of origin when Nathan was getting rid of that ball, he got clobbered. You got to give Nathan a lot of credit for standing in there. He could see that man coming at him, and he lets go of a long pass. And in the process, you can see one of the Chieftains actually gets hurt. But give Nathan a lot of credit for standing in the pocket that time and delivering that pass.
And one of the players who hit Dean is down injured for Logan back at the 45-yard line. Hopefully that young man is okay. And we have an injury timeout. Buckeyes up 41-6 with 4:08 to play in the game. Injured player for Logan was Michael Simpson, and he did go off under his own power, and that's good to see.
Yeah, you and I have talked about it more than once, Jim. The last thing we want to see is an actual injury against any kids on either team on any given Friday night.
Nathan Dean with the extra point attempt, and it is up. It looks good, and it is good. 42-6, Buckeyes, 4:08 to play. Nathan Dean will kick it away for the Buckeyes.
You know, Jim, just 37 seconds ago, the Buckeyes only had a 29-6 lead. They've scored twice in the last 36 seconds to take a 42-6 lead now with 4 minutes to play in a ballgame.
Low liner up the field, taken at the 24. Return man still going. And that was Nick Cost on the return.
Stopped by Dylan Cheeseman. I'm not sure who tripped him up first that time. Nice job by the Buckeyes again on the coverage team.
Logan first and 10 on their own 40. Kelly Long at quarterback for the Chieftains out of the shotgun. Three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Takes a snap, throws quickly to this side, and it's knocked down, I believe, by Isaiah Mello.
Isaiah Mello almost caught that with his left hand, actually, instead of just knocking it down.
Go, Second down and 10 for Logan.
I believe that to be the third or fourth tipped pass for the Buckeyes defensive line tonight.
Chieftains, once again, three receivers to the far side, one to this side. Long takes a snap. He'll run it to the left side. And he's still going after he breaks a tackle, runs into his own man, and takes it to the Buckeye 44-yard line as he picks up about 16 yards.
Brought down by number two, Austin North, and number 52, Cody Walker, that time for the Buckeyes.
.347 to play in the fourth quarter. The Buckeyes leading 42-6. Austin Emmon in for the Buckeyes, playing linebacker. Long out of the shotgun, looking to throw. Does so, and it's knocked away by Emmon. Immediately makes his presence felt.
Yeah, if you notice, the Buckeyes do have a lot of kids that moved in and out of there. Like I said, Cody Walker's out there on the defensive end position. You've got Neil Pauly and Isaiah McCombs on the defensive interior for the Buckeyes right now. And that just, again, shows the depth. Week in and week out, we talk about it, but just not in the skilled positions, but on the line, both offensively, defensively. You know, we've just got kids that are able to play in a lot of different situations.
Long out of the shotgun. And Long will keep it himself. He's at the 30, the Buckeyes at 25, and taken down right around the 19.
Breeze takes him down, but he gets 25 on the carry that time.
3:14 to play. Buckeyes up 42-6.
That was really nothing more than a broken play as he went to make the pass out to the flat, and he knew if he threw it out there, it was going to get intercepted again. So he very wisely held onto the ball, turns and runs upfield, and just found an open seam off to the right-hand side that time as he gets down inside the 20.
Chieftains, three receivers to the far side, one to this side. McCarty, the lone back. Quick pass out to the far side. Buckeyes, good coverage, taken down at the line of scrimmage. Dakota Hook.
Dakota Hook on the stop that time is number 14. Zach Dixon catches the ball, and Dakota Hook just picked him up and laid him down like he was on the wrestling mat that time. Takedown goes to Hook. 0 yards on the pass reception for the Chieftains.
Second down and 10 for Logan at the Buckeye 20. Long out of the shotgun, low snap, keeps it himself. Still going is Kelly Long. Finally taken down at the Buckeye 12-yard line as he picks up about 8.
Covert in on the stop that time for the Buckeyes defensively. And now we're down to, as they would say in the NFL, the 2-minute warning.
But of course in high school, the clock does not stop. It keeps rolling.
Which is good for the Buckeyes tonight, being up 42-6. They just want this clock to continue to tick.
Third down and about 2 for Logan at the Buckeye 12 with 1:45 to play in the game.
And you know, Jim, it's hard to believe, but tonight, Buckeyes go 5-0 halfway through the season, halfway to their 10-0 goal.
Long is sacked. And I believe that is
Neil Pauly
on the sack for the Buckeyes.
Somehow he shed his block and came in there untouched, it looked like, as Neil just dropped in that time.
Neil Pauly, a 6'1", 260-pound sophomore for Nelsonville York. And it'll bring up fourth down and about 6 for the Chieftains, just outside the Buckeye 15-yard line. Long out of the shotgun, three receivers to the far side. Option comes this side, pitch out to McCarty. The Buckeyes have it covered, and he'll go down for a loss.
Nice job by Dylan Cheeseman of the Buckeyes, along with Covert that time.
Buckeyes hold on downs.
Turnover on the fourth down for the Buckeyes.
56 seconds to play in the fourth quarter, and the Buckeyes leading by 36.
And you know, you and I were talking about it earlier. I know they took two quick timeouts here in the second half. I believe Chieftains have one more timeout left. Not enough to stop this. The Buckeyes really don't even need a first down in this particular series.
And the Buckeyes will be in victory formation.
They'll take the knee a couple times and walk away again. The Buckeyes are going to go 5-0 here tonight. And believe it or not, we are already halfway through the 2011 football season.
Nathan Dean takes a knee, clock running at 50 seconds. I doubt Logan will use their final timeout.
Both teams are lining up to shake hands already. As the Buckeyes, like you said, are going to take one more knee, and that ought to do it.
Play clock down to 10 seconds. Game clock at 26 now. Dean drops back, takes a knee. Clock running at 14 seconds.
We know there was a lot of talk about the Buckeyes coming up against this Logan Chieftains squad. The Logan Chieftains have played a very tough schedule coming into tonight's game. And the Buckeyes haven't played a team the size on the line and some of the skill positions, as you've seen here, against Logan. But the Buckeyes, again, offensively and defensively, are up for the challenge and show that they're for real this year, Jim.
Buckeyes win it 42-6. Nelsonville York now 5-0 on the season. Unbelievable that we're halfway through the regular season already. Logan drops to 0-5. Next week, the Buckeyes again will play right here at Boston Field against the Wellston Golden Rockets to open up league play in the Tri-Valley Conference's Ohio Division. Logan will play at Gallia Academy. Of course, Logan in the SEOAL. The Chieftains, a Division II team. Buckeyes, Division V. Of course, Nelsonville York will get nice first-level points, beating Logan, being a Division II team. And, of course, Buckeyes will now cheer for the Chieftains as they play teams like Chillicothe and some of those bigger schools on their schedule to come up with a two or three wins on the season.
Yeah, you know, the way the point system is set up, you want to beat every team you play, but you start rooting for them whenever they're not on the field against you, because every time they win, it benefits you. And the Buckeyes, like you said, you know, we're halfway through the season, so the point system does become critical. You start watching where your standings are in each region. The Buckeyes, you know, had some nice second-level points last week, come up with some great first-level points tonight, and definitely going to be looking to see if some of the other teams they've played in the past, Bishop Reedy, Newark Catholic, Trimble, and the likes of those guys, can pull off some wins tonight to help the Buckeyes again in the points, as they've moved last week to fourth in the region and look to maintain that position moving forward.
Tell you what, it was a special night tonight. Of course, even before this big game got underway, of course, celebrating the 30th anniversary of Nelsonville York's 1981 state football championship in Division IV. And it was really neat seeing the old players again, some of them haven't seen since back at that time.
You know, there was a lot of talk about people were wondering how many of those players would show up, how many would be here. But you could see when they came out at the beginning of the game, there was a great showing for the Nelsonville York Buckeyes championship team. And it just shows the tradition that the Nelsonville York Buckeyes have had year in and year out. Because if you didn't have somebody that you knew specifically on that team, you knew somebody that was associated with somebody with that team. And it's just something that you now watch this group of kids in 5-0. And the expectations and just like I said, just the amazing tradition that the Buckeyes carry here at Nelsonville York.
That state championship year in 81, the Buckeyes defeated the Chieftains by a score of 40-0. And again, what a year that was back in 1981. And of course, what a year the Buckeyes are having here in 2011, going undefeated on their non-conference schedule.
Well, you know, again, not only going undefeated in a non-conference schedule, but we talked about it last year and this year. The Buckeyes made a decision starting the last couple years that they were going to schedule very tough games and top-caliber playing teams and they're not out of conference. And they've taken that challenge and they've made the best of it this year. They really, you know, I don't care what people want to say, Newark Catholic's down, this happened, that happened, but the Buckeyes scheduled them. Those are traditionally strong teams, the Bishop Reedys, the Newark Catholics, the Trimbles. These are teams that traditionally are in playoff positions year in and year out, and the Buckeyes met that challenge this year and just did an excellent job. All right, we're back here at Boston Field as everybody's finally filtering out of the stadium here, where the Buckeyes come away with a commanding win here tonight. Just, again, put on a great show, both offensively, defensively. Can't say enough about the Buckeyes in all aspects of the game. The line play, the blocking, the tackling, the turnovers, the special teams, everything. Really, the Buckeyes maximized their opportunities and did an extremely strong job in all aspects of the game. Logan on the offensive side of the ball, you know, Logan, first half, they were in the air for four passes for nine attempts and 10 yards. Second half, Long comes in. The junior quarterback throws the ball eight times, five completions on eight attempts for 70 yards. So passing, you ended up with 9 out of 17 for the Chieftains and 80 yards. And interception by Perkins again on that situation. And a lot of great play in the secondary for the Buckeyes defensively. On the rushing attack for the Logan Chieftains, overall they were 35 carries for 160 yards. And McCarty was the number one individual on the rushing attack tonight. He had 18 carries for 101 total yards, and that was the extent of it. But they were able to move the ball a little bit more effectively in the second half. You know, I was mentioning they had 59 total yards in the first half. They end up with 240 total. Again, they end up with 35 carries for 160 yards. A lot of that was Long scrambling out of the quarterback position, and a lot of it was not designed. It was the pressure that the Buckeyes defensive line was putting on him and forcing him to scramble, and he was finding some positive yards. Now, for the Buckeyes side of the ball, first of all, I just want to make the point again that we've got so many different weapons out there. You know, when you start looking at the different individuals that put the ball in the end zone, you've got the rushing attack. You had Dustin Young, Clint Handa, Austin North. And then on the receiving side of things, you had Daniel Klein. So you have four different individuals that put the ball into the end zone yet again tonight. It just consistently shows how flexible and versatile the offense is here for the Buckeyes. So, again, looking at the rushing attack, we're going to just run down the overall stats. The Buckeyes carried the ball 30 times for 257 yards. I have Austin North for four carries, 29 yards. Two of those were touchdowns, a 7-yard touchdown and a 2-yard touchdown. Clint Handa had three carries for, 49 yards. And one of his was a 39-yard touchdown run. Perkins ran the ball twice for 6 positive yards. And Dustin Young, again, was the leading rusher for the Buckeyes attack on the ground. Total of 21 carries, 173 yards, and a 40-yard touchdown run for Dustin again yet tonight. So, again, that puts the Buckeyes in a position where they had 30 carries for 257 yards. And the passing attack, the Buckeyes really ran the ball effectively enough that they didn't try to throw the ball as much. You know, last week it was the passing game that opened up the running game for the Buckeyes. They came out and threw the ball for 181 yards in the first half last week. And this week the Buckeyes have a total of 107 yards in the air. Nathan was 7 of 14 in the air. Again, 107 total yards. Breeze had a catch for 3 yards. Dustin Young had a catch for 13. Freer had a catch for 9 yards. And Daniel Klein was the main target tonight with 4 catches, 82 yards. Two of those were touchdowns, a 35 and a 40-yard touchdown. So the Buckeyes, you know, overall 257 on the ground, 107 in the air, a total of 364 offensive yards. Again, the Buckeyes just did just about everything right. They had a few penalties that hurt them at certain situations, a couple pass interference penalties, and they were jumping off sides a little bit there for a while. But once they got all that under control, they got themselves in a real good position to, you know, just like you said early, they found a way to drive the ball and put that clinching touchdown there with about 4:44 to go in the fourth quarter that just really put it out of range.
Congratulations. Head coach Dave Boston Jr. of the Buckeyes, and of course, assistant coaches Jay Klein, Ernie Perkins, Eric Dean, Eric Mitchell, Charlie Altier, Jack Sowers, Jason Andrews. Of course, they put in a lot of time. Of course, the players and coaches both put a lot of time and effort into this, and right now it's paying off. The Buckeyes 5-0.
5-0, starting TVC play next week. You know, from what we heard, Alexander and Athens are both winning. It'll be interesting to see how things, you know, turn out there, but that would mean that the TVC Ohio still has 3 undefeated teams, and, you know, that's the way the Buckeyes are looking as they come down the road to matching up with those individuals. Again, looking at those second level points, you want to win first, but anything you get beyond that win in the second level makes a huge difference when it comes to the playoff picture for you.
And Trimble was leading by about 3 touchdowns last we heard, so again, that's good for the Buckeyes on those second level points you were talking about. Once again, the final score here at Boston Field. It was a great night for the Buckeyes of Nelsonville, York. They defeat the Chieftains of Logan by a final score of 42-6. For Chance Fox on camera and Ray Spouts, this is Jim McCumber saying, so long, everybody.